view.
Are you ready to get on the trail?
We're back. This is where it all happened before.
My broken arm.
Bucktail Trail at Halfmoon Mountain. About to get on the trail. We're gonna do 10 miles, 2,200 feet of climb. Let's go.
Hey, the last time I was here, I fell and broke my arm 3 miles in when that happened.
Titanium plate in there. At least it's titanium, lightweight. This time we hope not to break any bones.
But that's my plan, not to break any bones.
Today we're going to be doing about 5.5 miles. We're going to sleep up on the peak of Half Moon Mountain. There is no water at our campsite tonight, so we're going to have to make sure we fill up. This is actually a winter trip, doing this hike in February, but with the unseasonably warm weather. Taking advantage of it, and we're actually wearing shorts and t-shirts. First mile or so along this fire road is uphill. Soon we'll be at the bone break point. What do you think?
I know, I'm kind of excited.
Sounds like the frog army. Some crazy frogs in that hole.
Coming up on the spot where I had my most unfortunate accident.
This is the tree that Lisa broke her arm on. I'm just kidding, it's not this tree. Coming up on the river here in a few minutes, 2.5 miles in. I think I can see the creek down there. Hey, if you like our videos, we have a lot more on our YouTube channel, Ot Mountain. Well, this is not the tree that Lisa broke her arm on, but there is a new blowdown here that we're gonna have to get around.
That is insane.
We could probably just work our way down here
yeah.
And around. Working our way around this obstacle. Just being super extra careful. When you're moving around obstacles with a pack, you gotta really be careful. There's a lot of things that can go wrong. I'm taller than I'm normally, so if I go under this and I hit the top of my pack, it could send you backwards. The thing that got Lisa in trouble last time as she was going around an obstacle was shifting center of gravity and not having enough points of contact, what we'll show you in a minute. Heading down to the creek now. Well, we arrived at the footbridge here on the right. I guess it's actually made for horses. 2.5 miles we've come so far. Felt pretty good, how do you feel?
Yeah, it felt really good actually.
Right at the bridge crossing, there is a campsite. Trail's winding around by the creek. We're almost at the bone crusher moment. The moment you earned your nickname, bone crusher.
There's the tree, I see it. Pretty high off the ground. I did fall pretty far.
The river was much lower then, and when the trail got blocked here, we went around to the left and straddled the tree, got over the top. I made it over, and then Lisa got stuck with both feet off the ground.
Right. Then my center of balance shifted when I tried to swing my other leg up and over, and I just went straight down into the ground, into the rock. And that's how it's done. I did it.
So how does it feel to have conquered your fears?
I'm very excited to have actually made it over. There is the spot. Those are the rocks that I hit. So I was sitting perched up there and swung my other leg over and I just fell straight down to those rocks and had put my arm out in front of me.
Show them your titanium plate. Oh gosh, no longer fully human. All right, well, you feel like conquered some new territory?
Yeah, it'll be good to see what we missed out on last time.
Just gotta keep an eye on the water, and when this creek separates from the trail, we're gonna have to fill up. Another river crossing. Lots of potential campsites along the trail here.
Third river crossing, woohoo!
Number four.
Crossing,
there's five in total, so one more to go. Well, that creek back there was fourth, so we should have one more to go, and then we're gonna be pulling out of this valley, fifth and last river crossing. We're gonna stop here for lunch. Good job, last one.
Thank goodness.
What kind of water purification system do you use? We typically use the Platypus Gravity Works. You scoop dirty water into the bag that says dirty water. You then run that water through this filter into your clean bag. We can purify about 2 liters at a time. So right now I'm gonna go ahead and purify a bunch of water, and then we're going to drink as much as we can before we leave, and then I'm gonna take some dirty water so we can filter again up on top of the mountain. Hey, lunchtime. We're about 3.3 miles in. Generally for short trips like this, 10 miles or less, one-nighter, we tend to bring real food for the first day, so lunch, dinner is just gonna be food. It does make our pack weights a little bit heavier. We are not trying to go ultra light here today. We have pretty heavy packs.
So hey, we just finished up with lunch. We refueled our bodies and we're ready to finish out the hike for the day.
So my pack weight has gone up a lot since lunch. With all the extra water that we have, carrying about 4 extra liters. So what was already kind of a heavy pack is now 4 liters heavier. How are we doing, Bone Crusher? Over.
Long, slow slog, but I'm slogging it up.
10-4. Wait for you here. Over. Reason we got radios is for safety. I do tend to hike a little bit faster than Bone Crusher. Trying this out, and in our larger group hikes, this will be a safety mechanism. The lead guy and the back person will both have radios. We're gonna try it out.
Hey, so we're 4 miles into the hike. We just came off of the Bucktail Trail, and now we're gonna turn right onto the German Wilson Trail.
We're gonna be going up on top of that mountain. Now we're gonna start heading up the hill. Climbing up German Wilson Trail, even though it's only 0.8 miles, it's straight up. How's that new pack feeling?
Hey, it feels pretty good. This is the Gregory DIVA 70 liter. Suspension's a little different, but I like it.
We're just below the intersection with the Halfmoon Mountain Trail, and just want to report there is water running to my right. Bone Crusher, come in.
Here, over.
Just hit the first switchback almost at the saddle of Halfmoon Mountain. Over. Come on, you knew we had to play with the radios at some point. German Wilson Trail, it's rocky. Coming out of this little gorge, this hill is redonkulous. Is that the steepest trail you've ever been on?
I think it is the steepest trail I've ever been on. I feel like I'm climbing Mount Everest. Saddle up, baby.
I think we've done probably 1,100 feet of climb just from that last trail intersection. Just made it up to the crest or the saddle. That was a really bad climb, tough. Hopefully we got another half a mile to the campsite and we're gonna be camping up on the ridge. Whew. Let it fly on me. Tomorrow we're gonna be coming back this way.
Okay.
We're at the Half Moon Mountain cutoff trail. It's 0.4 miles up to what's supposed to be a couple of campsites. Starting to get into some big views up here. Past the campsite that they refer to on hiking upward. We're gonna continue on to the summit. It is beautiful up here. We haven't seen anybody all day either. Close to the summit, trail veers off and goes straight up here. Wow, some views. Man, incredible up here. Feels like you're on top of the world. About to summit. Yep, here it is. Summit of Half Moon Mountain. This is the little saddle campsite that they talked about on hiking upward. It's just right below the summit, which is there. Oh, it's spectacular up here. Still trying to decide if we want to camp here or not. We've got a little bit of wind up here, and it's not the biggest area in the world, but it is nice up here, that's for sure. All right, we decided we're gonna go back down to that big campsite right at the base of the mountain, just because there's more room. And so it's a little less breezy there. After hauling our packs up the extra 50 yards. Well, it is a lot less breezy down here at this campsite. And we've got a nice big area here. There is a fire ring here. Not a lot of flat spots for tents, but we think we can probably make do either here. But the nice thing is you got views all around over there and over here, there's a valley. We can still go up to the summit. It's just 25 yards. Without pack, it'll be a lot easier. Well, let's get camp set up. Hey, gonna give you a quick demonstration of our sleep system. We are using the Big Agnes sleep system. These are the Q Core insulated pads. Of course, they pack down really light, kind of a hassle to blow up. And then I'm gonna show you how the sleeping bag system works with it. Start by turn the valve, blowing them up. Are you enjoying this? All right, once the pads are inflated, you take your sleeping bag, which this is the Lost Ranger, and she has got the Roxy Ann. These are 15 degree rated bags. The bottom of the bag, they have these sleeves. We're gonna slide the pad in through. And there you go, sleep system set up.
Hey, all right, we have camp all set up. So now we're gonna head up to the summit and take a little wine and watch the sunset.
We brought all of our food with us because we're not leaving anything behind here. While maybe rodents and stuff could be getting to it. Now, I didn't feel like hanging a bear bag just yet. Wow, this sunset's gonna be ridiculous. Super windy right here. So I think this is just beyond the saddle campsite. If you just keep going a little bit, you get to this awesome view. But it is windy, windy, wow. Windy. You can hear it, right?
Woo!
This view is ridiculous.
Amazing.
We haven't told you yet. Tomorrow is Bone Crusher's birthday, so we're gonna be celebrating her birthday up here on the mountain. Happy birthday to Bone Crusher. I give you all of this as your gift. Who needs an actual gift when I give you this? View at Odd Mountain, encourage, no, we don't we don't encourage it, but we actually do like to bring along adult beverage from time to time. So we're gonna toast not only the sunset, we're gonna toast my favorite lady's birthday, which is tomorrow. So, whoa, spilling. It's precious cargo, man. I lugged that son of a gun up a lot of miles today. We did about, what, 6 miles to get here?
So,
well, cheers, happy cheers. Birthday, happy sunset, cheers. It's windy up here.
Oh my goodness.
So glad we got the campsite down below.
Yeah, I think so.
God, this wind is ridiculous. Glad you came along. I got you these mountains, I got you that sunset for your birthday.
Best presents I've ever had.
I don't need to get you a present.
I love it.
I got you that. I did get her an actual present, just so you don't worry, I'm good. Got it covered.
Oh! Oh, oh, oh!
Oh!
Oh, oh, oh!
The sun is dipping below the mountain right now.
Amazing.
Everybody should watch a sunset like that, at least. Month or so, you know, be a better world. Gotta help make everybody just like mellow. Hey, tonight we're gonna be doing some primitive cooking. We're gonna be just cooking some real food. We got some steak, we got some mashed potatoes and some vegetables. We're gonna be cooking them right on the fire.
Vegetables, we won't be able to finish now. More of it.
We had a nice little meal.
I think it's time to tell a scary story at the campfire.
What was that?
That's my thought. Beautiful night. The sky is lit up with stars.
All right, we're going to bed.
Woo. Ready for bed.
See you in the morning. Good night.
See
and
you in your
we'll
dreams.
See you
in
the
dreams.
Tent. Oh, hey, good morning. About 8 o'clock. Yeah, we slept in. Had a little rough night. Birthday girl here. She had a nightmare in which someone was dragging the tent and throwing it off a cliff. She was so convinced it was real that she like made me get up immediately. And I didn't know what's going on. I thought maybe literally there were people outside or, you know, banditos coming to get us. So it scared the crap out of me. Came back in the tent. So it was just a dream. We're gonna get up and make some breakfast. See you in a minute. It was a little bit of a rough night, very windy. At one point, Lisa thought someone was outside. Just so you get your orientation here, the peak of Halfmoon Mountain is up there. The trail is there. The sunrise is there. Sunset, which we saw last night, would be over there. So this is a great sight because you're gonna get full east to west sun here. It's a little cloudy this morning. Sun did rise and we missed it. Yeah, thought about getting up, but then I got thought again. Ain't happening. A little chilly, but not too bad. We did lose our water last night. Did not put the cap on, put the bag in the tent. Lost it. That's our drinking water, not all of it. We still have Lisa's supply, which is about 2 liters, so we should be good. Drinking water, and I still have the dirty water I brought yesterday. Just really important to not take for granted the water supply when you don't have a running river nearby. That's the second time in a row where we've had a water issue up on top of a mountain, and it's not fun to have to ration water. To reiterate, it's so windy up here. There's another good lookout right here, and down there you can see the Trout Run Valley. That's where we hiked out of yesterday.
Boiling some water with the Jetboil, getting ready to have some coffee, hopefully. I need it. So good morning. All right, so we're getting ready to make up our freeze-dried food, spicy hash. So
freeze-dried food, but it's pretty good. It's got a little spice to it. Well, the rains are coming a little bit here. A little earlier than I'd hoped because we're not done taking down the tents. Hey, we're just leaving camp as the rains are coming.
Yep.
We're gonna be doing about 4.7 miles down the hill back to the car. The pack's a lot lighter today because spilled the water and ate all the food and whatever wine we had. We got rid of that too, so feels a little bit better. Legs are a little sore.
So hey, we've just left our camp. You can see where we were. Halfmoon Mountain is right there, and our camp was right on the edge of that. It's a really cool space.
Just hiking along towards our next intersection. We're hiking along a ridge. This is the large campsite that they talk about on hiking upward. It's right before the Half Moon Mountain Trail. All right, we're coming up in the intersection of the Half Moon Mountain Trail. Slowly making our way downhill to the Bucktail Cutoff Trail.
Hey, there's our campsite. This descent sure does beat yesterday's ascent. This is nice.
Finally getting back down to the creek here for water if we needed it, but luckily I think we have enough water to get back to the car.
Okay, so we just came down our portion of the Half Moon Trail, which is this direction. We're gonna bear right and head down to the Bucktail Cutoff Trail, and at this intersection is a really nice large campsite.
This is the campsite it's talked about on the hiking upward. On this Bucktail Cutoff Trail, there's 5 gullies that you gotta climb in and out of. So you're not out of the woods yet. You know, a lot of climbing left to do.
Woohoo! That little hill was pretty tough even. Woo. Woo. I did it!
Bucktail Connector Trail will leave you gassed. Our 5 gullies. Starting to get some rain and a cold front came through. It suddenly dropped in temperature. There's the fire road.
Yay!
Almost done. Hey, we're coming to the end of our hike, our backpack trip. We did about 10.5 miles one night, 2,200 feet of climb. It was a good hike. And our good friend Bone Crusher did not break her arm. This time, so congratulations and happy birthday.
Thank you very much. I conquered the trail. I did not let the trail conquer me. Woohoo, finally.
If you have any questions about our backpack trip, please post them below. We'll try to answer. We definitely recommend this hike. Really, really nice up on the summit of Half Moon Mountain. Thanks again for coming along with us. Please subscribe to our channel, Ott Mountain, and get more updates. In the meantime, from Ott Mountain, I'm Otter Pop.
And I'm Bone Crusher.
And we'll see you on the trail.